What's up, everybody, and welcome to another segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime, continuing the face scans and the player ratings for each of respective teams that are in NBA Elite 11. So if you haven't watched the Detroit Pistons and the actual Atlanta Hawks, gladly go ahead and do so. Now I'm on the Boston Celtics and the Boston Celtics. Well, you already know how the Celtics were made up. They had a squad. So without further ado, I am going to break it down. And for the ones that need to get to the other videos, I'm just going to keep on repeating this because I know a lot of people, they really don't pay attention to it, but you should, because that way you can get to the other material and that way you will be up to date and informed on a lot of stuff. Everything will be in the description box below, or it will be in the suggestion tag that is coming across in the right hand corner that you will see numerous times coming across. You click on that, you take your mouse, you go up there, you click on it, and click on the respective video that you want or the link that's in the description box, and go from there. So let's go ahead and break this all down. So we got the Boston Celtics, and we got my main man Rajon Rondo. As y'all see, I'm gonna spin him around. Yes, indeed, right there. So let's go ahead and get all into it with my boy. And this is Rondo. They did a great job on Rajon. They did an excellent job on Rondo, as a matter of fact. Not too bad. And they got his body type too, so that's not the thing. So there you go, Rajon Rondo. So let's go ahead and go to the next. We got Paul Pierce, the truth. The truth will set you free, Paul Pierce. As you see there, let's go ahead and check them out. Yeah, they did a good job on Paul. They did a great job on Paul, actually. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. And this is Paul. Let's see if they got anything on his. Oh, yeah, and you see on his sleeve, they got his actual, the truth on his sleeve, as you see here. The truth, 24. And again, like I always state, that was one thing EA has always done. They've always paid attention to detail when it came down to the players. And before they went into the next, to the 8th gen with 14 and so forth, with 14 and 15, 16, 18, and 19, they kind of fell off on a little, you know, elements when it came down to detail, when it came down to players. So, you know, they got to get back to that. So the next player that we got Ray Allen, Jesus Shuttlesworth himself, Ray Ray. Yes, sir. Let's go ahead and take a look at Ray Lewis. I mean, Ray Allen. There you go. Look at Ray. They did a great job on Ray Allen. Can't say no more, no less. They did a great job on Ray. Let's go ahead and get up on out of that. Next, we're going to go to the Hall of Famer himself, KG, the big ticket. Yes, sir. That's one of my favorite players ever played the game. There you go. I think all you Boston fans would be really happy because he's going to have his jersey retired in Boston. So, there you go. And KG, they did a good job on him. Can't take it away from him on that. Did a real good job. See his shading. See his beard. Did a good shade on it. So, can't get mad at that. Let's go ahead with his body, with his tats, as you can see. And they got his tats. Yes, they do. KG. Go down to the lower body. They don't even have it up there for him, but there you go. And that is Kevin Garnett. Let's go ahead and get out of that. So next we're going to go to Jermaine O'Neal. Yes, sir. As y'all see, Jermaine. And Jermaine O'Neal. So let's go ahead. Oh, they did a great job on Jermaine O'Neal. Wow. That's a good one. And again, you know, I'm going to say this in all of the actual videos, is that when they transitioned over from NBA Live 10, now NBA Live 10, all these players are from Live 10, but they darkened them up. So they took that lighting, that extreme shading, and they toned it down, and they did in NBA Elite 11. So that's why the players look the way they look. So if you compare from NBA Live 10 to over to NBA Elite, then you'll see the complete difference. So they may not move like they did in Live 10, but they definitely did a great job on the player models and the way they did the shading and the coloring on the players. As you see Jermaine O'Neal's tattoos. So, and they did a great job on it. So I will never take that away on what EA did with that. Now, mind you, ladies and gentlemen, this is on PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. So if y'all are trying to compare graphically and visually to what we have now, that's not fair. So, you know, a lot of people, you have to really, really know that. Next, we go into the Diesel. We got the Whale himself. They did a good job on the Whale, Shaquille O'Neal. We're going to basically take a look at his tats as well. He got a lot of tats on Shaq. He ain't got that many tats. Now, that is wrong, because Shaq don't have that many tats. He don't have that many. Not too bad of a Shaq. He did a good job on him. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Let's go ahead and take a look at his tats. As y'all see, and they got the Superman on there. Yes, indeed. And as you see, they got the Diesel on there. They got the Man of Steel on there. There you go. And that is the Whale. That is the Diesel. Let's get up on out of there. We're going to go to Little Nate. Nate Robinson. Little Nate. Little Nate. Little Nate. Hold on, let me go back. There you go. They did a good job on Nate Robinson. I will give them that. Yes, indeed. They did. They did a good job on Nate. Can't get mad at that one. Y'all tell me how y'all feel about it. Y'all tell me. Let's go ahead and go to his actual tats. Oh, yeah. They did a good job on the tats. And as you see, like, the difference in players, because some players' tats are going to be a little bit more visible than others. So, which is a good thing. As you see with Nate and what he got. Let's get up on out of there. Next, we're going to go to Big Perk. Kendrick Perkins. So we're going to go to Big Perk. Let's see what he got. What he looking like. Oh yeah, they did a good job on Big Perk. Yep. Good job on Big Perk. Can't even get mad at that. It's a good job. Good job on Big Perk. Let's go ahead and go on down. Check out his tats. So, and as y'all see there, yep, they got the signature his tats. So let's get up on out of there. So we got Von Wafer. Yes, indeed. We're going to take a look at him. He got those J's on. Let's take a look. Yep, that's Von Wafer. Oh, that's an excellent one, Von Wafer. Dang, they did a good job on Von Wafer. Wow. They even got his Adam's apple sticking out. That's a good one. Okay. I'm not even mad at that. Let's take a look at his tats. Oh, yeah. They did a good job on Von Wafer. Real good job. I'll give him that. Let's go ahead and go to the next player. We got Big Baby Davis. Big Baby. Yeah, y'all can see him. Let's go ahead and take a look at his girl. Oh, yeah. Not bad. Not too shabby on his face. Nice one on Big Baby. Can't get mad at that one. It's a real, real nice one. Real, real good, actually. Yes, indeed. Let's get up on out of that. We're going to go to Marquise Daniels. Let's take a look. Oh, yeah. That's excellent. Oh, yeah. They did a good job on Marquise. Wow. Let's go ahead and take a look at his mug. Yeah, they got the sleepy look on him. Yeah. Now, remember, this game does have emotions in it, so it does do that. So those emotions are going to change, but that's what they look like. Yeah, Marquise Daniels did look like a zombie. That's not too shabby, though. There's Marquise Daniels. Let's go ahead and take out his tats. Man, he had a lot of them, so. Yes, he did. Even the ones on his neck. Not too shabby. Let's get up on out of there. Let's go to Luke Harangode. I can't pronounce his name. Harangode. Hey, I don't know. I can't pronounce it. Hey, it is what it is. It is what it is. Let's go ahead and take a look at the scan. Yeah, just pretty regular. Yeah, but the hair texture is the main thing. It was good, so get on there. Let's go to the next player. We're going to go to Avery Bradley. Oh, yeah, and they don't have Avery Bradley's face scan. Nope. That's not him, so I don't need to really look at it because that's not Avery Bradley. But as you see, that's the Avery Bradley. And Avery Bradley was, I think Avery Bradley was a rookie that year. That's probably why. And last but not least, we got Shamet Erden. I don't even know. We got Erden. He's 7 feet. Let's take a look at his face. Ah, not too shabby. He did a good job. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. So let's go ahead and take a look at everybody's ratings. So the first player that we got Big Perk on his rating. So gladly go ahead and take a look at this as I break it on, as I go on down. And y'all already know the routine with it. I don't really don't, you know, for the ones that's looking at it, you could take a look at the ratings and then go from there. Next, we got the truth. We got Paul Pierce. Yes, his mid-range game should be extremely high. So, you know, they got Paul like crazy. Yes, indeed. His layup is good. That's Paul Pierce. Now we got Little Nate. Little Nate. Nate Robinson. Yes, indeed. So as you see there. That's his anticipation. Next, we have Rajon Rondo. His awareness should be really very high. I think his awareness, it should be high. His passing should be good. His, I know his stealing should be good. His shooting is not going to be all that great. His free throws are not going to be that great. That's a significance. Hands are real good. There you go. Passability and dribbling. Excellent. Yes, excellent. Next, we got Von Wafer. Let's take a look. Let's go on down. Yes, indeed. Nice. Next, we got Jesus Shuttlesworth Ray Allen. Yes, indeed. Next, we got Avery Bradley. His defense should be extremely high. Well, if he's a rookie in here, I think that he's a rookie. I'm not sure. All right. Next, we got Marquise Daniels. Yes, indeed. Next, we got Big Baby Davis, Glenn Davis. And just look at the way they have the rating system. So I'll break that all down in another segment. And we got Erden, so I'll just go past him. Let's go past everybody so that way you'll actually see his stuff and what it is. So we got done with him. We got the ticket. We got KG. Shot block, his steal, his post defense. Yes, sir. His mid-range, his free throw, go-to guy. Yes, indeed. And then we got Luke. Harangle Day. Oh. And Jermaine O'Neal. The Boston Celtics were extremely deep, you know, but if it wasn't for all those injuries, man, they probably could have did some damage this following that year. Then we got the Diesel. Yeah, if it wasn't for all the injuries, man, because they was big in the interior, and they had a lot of injuries that year, because I remember, the big old whale. And that is the Boston Celtics and NBA Elite 11, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, make sure you comment. Let me know how you feel about it. Make sure y'all hit that like button. The more likes, the more exposure the video gets. Everything will be in the description box below. That means the playlist for all NBA Elite 11 content. Also, at the top in the right-hand corner is the suggestion. Suggestions for which videos that you can actually look at, and I would gladly appreciate it if you do so. So for me to you, the NBA Live Godfather, if you know, you know, but if you didn't know, your boy Prime always going to bring it to you, NBA Live. All right, y'all, I'm out of here. Peace.